What number are you up to now? How much have you identified of the money he's taken in from foreign nationals?
We have more bank records coming in, but we're going to exceed 10 million this week, and I think we'll get up between 20 and 30 million.
Well, that was House Oversight Committee Chairman Congressman James Comer with me on Mornings with Maria this week on Fox Business on Thursday, with his expectations of identifying up to $30 million so far, that money that was taken in by Joe Biden and his family in this alleged decades-long influence peddling scheme we've been talking about. Comer also revealing details from the FBI document alleging a specific bribe by Ukraine, the Burisma executive who claims to have paid both President Biden and his son Hunter $5 million apiece, reportedly made 17 audio recordings of his conversations, two of those recordings with President Biden and two others with Hunter Biden, negotiating the terms of their deal and accepting the money. On Thursday, President Biden was asked why Hunter's business deals refer to him as the big guy.
Why did the Ukraine FBI informant file refer to you as the big guy? Why is that term particularly applied?
Thank you very much.
Thanks, guys. Why did that such a direct question?
All of this among the reasons some House Republicans have talked about drawing up articles of impeachment against President Joe Biden. Joining me right now with more on all of this and this investigation are Georgia Congresswoman Marjorie Taylor Greene and Arizona Congressman Andy Biggs, both members of the House Oversight Committee. Thanks very much for being here. Marjorie Taylor Greene, let me kick things off with you and ask you to tell us where this investigation stands. I know you're waiting for more bank records. What can you tell us?
Well, we subpoenaed more bank records last Friday, and while we're waiting for those, we're expecting to see tens of millions of dollars exposed that went to the Biden family. But the shocking part is, Maria, that we have the FBI director, Christopher Wray, that refused to hand over an unclassified form, the 1023, to our oversight committee that Andy Biggs and I both sit on under Chairman Comer. The other shocking part is that not only did he force us to read this unclassified form in a skiff, he redacted not only names, which is actually more understandable, but he redacted the most important part of information on there is that there was 17 audio recordings, 15 of Hunter, 2 of Joe Biden himself, about Joe Biden taking a $5 million bribe. How dare Christopher Wray have the audacity to hide this information for his boss, Joe Biden? This is purely protecting crimes. He's hiding crimes the president of the United States committed when he was vice president. And that's where we stand right now.
Well, that's nothing new. They've been stonewalling all of you from day one. What are you going to do about it?
Maria,
I personally believe we have to hold him accountable. Go ahead, Andy.
Yeah, thanks, Marjorie. And I would tell you that the first step where we can hold these guys accountable is the Holman Rule. And that's where I think we go first. And that's where we can actually reorganize aspects of the FBI and people like Christopher Wray get held accountable that way. But Maria and Marjorie's really done a good job summarizing this, but there's also additional 1023s that we know of that Christopher Wray has been dragging his feet on those as well. And we're not sure exactly how much more information we're going to have and how much more this is going to tie in with Joe Biden. But again, Christopher Wray is taking 1023s. And don't forget, just 2.5 weeks ago, he said there wasn't any 1023s. And then when we finally pushed him on it, he said, okay, here you go. And then he redacts this important information.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you that the oligarch also indicated that he has additional communications besides these tapes with the Biden family. So it's pretty extensive. We think it's leading right into Joe Biden, and that means that we should be, and because what Marjorie said, I believe this is the biggest political scandal in the history of the country. You've got a vice president conducting illegal activity, and then you have the DOJ protecting him.
Well, of course, it is the biggest political scandal any of us have ever seen. So that's why I want to get back to these tapes for a moment, because you just said that there are 15 recordings of Hunter Biden and 2 of Joe Biden. Andy Biggs, look, obviously, we need evidence. We've been talking about this for a long time. So far, the evidence has been bank records. Where are these tapes?
Well, we don't know. The oligarch kept the tapes for his own protection. The reason he did, and he said it in his 1023 statements that he was giving, he said, I'm doing this so that it'll take 10 years to link me to Joe Biden, and he's doing it for his own protection.
Wow.
And don't forget that he also said he felt coerced. So he's got the evidence. He's just been loath and been afraid.